Okay, good morning, church, and welcome to our morning devotion. And turn in our Bibles to John chapter 8 and verses 3 onwards. It says, "Then the scribes and the Pharisees brought to him a woman caught in adultery, and when they had set her in the midst, they said to Jesus, 'Teacher, this woman was caught in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned, but what do you say?'" In verse 7, when they continued asking him, he raised himself up and said to them, "Who is without sin among you? Let him throw a stone at her first." And verse 11, 10, when Jesus has raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, "Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you?" Verse 11, Jesus said, the woman said, "No one, Lord." And Jesus said to her, "Neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more." Let's pray. Father, we just thank you and pray for this few moments of this devotion. Anoint your servant. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, last week I was sharing few memories, my time with Pastor Carl, I just thought I'd share some more today. Now, one of the things I like about Pastor Carl was his simplicity. Many of you do not know, one of his favorite snack before the class on every Tuesday. Do you know what it is? Okay, that is sev puri. Okay, he would have the sev puri before every class on Tuesday. That's his favorite snack after a long day of meetings, and another thing was whenever we used to travel to Versailles, we would get down at the Versailles station, and then we would walk outside the east. There's a hotel there, and then we would have idli vada and medu vada. These are some of his. That's why it became so easy for us to gel with him, because he was like being a pastor. He was so simple, and I like his simplicity. And I was thinking also, apart from these fun moments with him, I was thinking another important aspect of Pastor Carl is, I have never seen a man so gracious. He is a very gracious man. In fact, in one of our team meetings, I believe many of you are in the team remember this, Pastor Carl once said, we were just talking about the aspect of grace and giving people grace. And he said, "I don't want to stand one day before Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ telling me, 'You should have given him more grace or given her more grace.'" And that thought really stuck in my heart. It's amazing to see that he operated in the fullness of God's grace. And a similar passage we see, I would define that as, he walked as Jesus walked. Remember, he did a series on those messages, walking as Jesus walked. And that was his clear ambition, his purpose on this earth, to walk and reveal Christ. And that's what we all saw in his life. And I was thinking today about, this wonderful characteristics of a man of God that we walked with as grace. Today I thought about grace. No, I was thinking as you're thinking about grace. Grace is we know, people, the Pharisees and the religious people, put Jesus on the cross. Among many reasons that they put him on the cross, one of the reasons they put him on the cross is because they couldn't fathom that Jesus could give grace to people whom they thought they were undeserving. This is fascinating. By the way, that is one of the reasons that they were jealous, in a sense, to see Jesus could eat with sinners. He could give grace to Nicodemus. He could give grace to Zacchaeus. He could give grace to Matthew, the tax collector. They couldn't fathom that thought. And that's what Jesus' life on this earth 2,000 years back. We just read a passage in this story. We see a group of religious Pharisees bring a woman to Jesus Christ, and she is caught in adultery. And they rightly said, according to the law of Moses, this woman need to be stoned to death. By the way, they didn't say anything wrong. They spoke as Moses wrote in the law. But Jesus said, Jesus did something amazing in this passage. More than forgiving this woman, he taught a very important principle for all of us, and we could glean. I just thought we'll observe three observations in this passage. Number one, Jesus knew that this woman is a sinner. In fact, he said at the end of the passage, he said, go and sin no more. Like Jesus knew where we are in our lives. You know, by the way, when people come into our lives and God sends people into our life, you know, our role is to give grace to people. You know, people are already condemned on this earth. Like they already know they made mistakes. They already know they are failures. And they made many mistakes in their lives. And when they come into our churches, when God brings them into our lives, we need to understand, we don't want to open up how sinful they are, and but we want to give grace to people. And when the woman was born, Jesus could have just said in front of everybody, I know that you are a sinner, but he covered her. And that's an amazing thought right now. Jesus knew she sinned, but he didn't open the mouth until everybody left. He said, no, go and sin no more. And that's the heart of Jesus Christ. No? And the second thing I see also, Jesus knew that that the woman is not the only one who committed sin, but all of them. Jesus made a definite principle there, or a statement here. Like there's no big sinner and small sinner. There's only one group of people on this earth. They are sinners. Jesus defined that clearly, and he said, whoever has not sinned, throw the first stone. That's amazing, isn't it? Like sometimes we get into, oh, this person has done this thing, or that person. But everybody are in the same category. That's where we need Jesus. That's where Jesus came on this earth. And that's where he want to give that grace to people. And thirdly, I see also, he said, whoever has not sinned, throw the first stone. We know the story, everybody left. Everybody came to the point that in their hearts, deep in their hearts, there's emptiness and there's sin in their hearts. And there in the scene, there's a woman and Jesus Christ. And Jesus is the only one who's qualified to throw the stone upon this woman. And he says to her, neither I condemn you. I was just thinking this thought in John chapter 3:17, when the passage where Nicodemus comes to Jesus. And Jesus says to Nicodemus, the Son of Man has not come to condemn this world, but to save this world. And I was thinking about this thought, grace. Grace is so important aspect in our lives and as believers. Jesus taught something like different. The Old Testament said, this is what you have to do, this is what. But Jesus said, like, no, get used to the different. My style is different. This is what the law say. But the new economy is grace. Like you're going to deal with, now God is going to deal people with grace, and he wants us as believers to deal people in grace. Don't think about what somebody did 10 years back or what somebody looked like 5 years back. And we could just ponder on those things, and I can just look at somebody and say, he is a vessel or she is a vessel of grace, because that's what Christ sees. If imagine you bring the biggest sinner today before Jesus Christ, he would simply say, you know, I give you grace. That's the heart of Jesus. No, that's the heart of Jesus. We don't want to be like these Pharisees and these religious, like we don't want to live in the old economy, but we live in the new economy. And Jesus said, get used to this new different. No, get used to this new different called grace. And what's amazing, when we walk in grace, people are drawn. Like people, the sinners, the tax collectors, and these people were drawn to Jesus. And that's amazing. And that's what our pastor taught all these years, like to live and grow, like in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.